Hello everyone, welcome to the third topic of this unit interference. The topic name was condition for interference of light. So, in order to obtain stationary interference pattern on the screen, it must satisfy the main six conditions. In this, first condition was shown in this animation. The first and foremost, we will consider Young's double slit experiment. We know that in this experiment, the two sources S1 and S2 emerged from the main source S. For example, consider the light wave emerging from light source S1 as contains phase difference delta 1, and also the light wave emerging from light source S2 as contains phase difference delta 2. If these two light sources of waves are superposed and form an interference pattern at P on the screen, then it must satisfy the condition delta 1 minus delta 2 is equal to 0, or the phase difference should be constant. That means the light waves having constant phase difference between them or zero phase difference between them, then only stable interference pattern is formed. That means the two interfering sources must emit waves having constant phase difference between them. If the phase difference does not remain constant, then the sustained interference pattern is not possible. That means, if the phase difference does not remain constant, then the sustained interference pattern is not possible. Next, the second condition was shown in this animation. Consider the light wave emerging from light source S1 having a wavelength lambda 1 or the frequency F1, and also the second light wave emerging from the light source S2 having wavelength lambda 2 or frequency F2. If these two light sources of waves are superposed and form an interference pattern at point P on the screen, then it must satisfy the condition lambda 1 is equal to lambda 2 or F1 is equal to F2. That means lambda 1 becomes lambda 2 or F1 and F2 are equal. Then only stable interference pattern is formed. Here the wavelength of light is inversely proportional to the frequency of the light. That's why second condition includes both wavelength and frequency equations. That means the two light sources should emit light same frequency or wavelength. Consequently, the resultant intensity attains alternatively be maximum and minimum. In case two sources are not having same frequency or wavelength, then no stable interference pattern is formed on the screen. Then the sustained interference pattern is not possible. Next, the third condition was shown in this animation. Consider the light wave emerging from the light source S1 having amplitude A1, and also the light wave emerging from light source S2 having amplitude A2. If these two light sources are superposed and form an interference pattern at P on the screen, then it must satisfy the condition A1 is equal to A2 or A1 approximately equal to A2. Then only stable interference pattern is formed. That means the two light sources should be emit the same amplitude or nearly same amplitude. That means if the two light sources are having the same amplitude, then maximum intensity becomes bright fringe and minimum becomes dark fringe. In case two sources are not having the same amplitude or nearly same amplitude, then no stable interference pattern is formed on the screen. Then the sustained interference pattern is not possible. If these two sources are satisfied the above three conditions, then these two sources are said to be coherent. Next, fourth condition was shown in this animation. If the light wave emerging from light source S1 and the light wave emerging from the light source S2 form an interference pattern at P on the screen, then the two sources should be narrow. In case two sources are not narrow, then no stable interference pattern is formed on the screen. Next, fifth condition was shown in this animation. If the light wave emerging from light source S1 and the light wave emerging from light source S2 form an interference pattern at P, then the two sources kept at very small distance. If these two sources are in very far distance, then fringe width becomes very less. As a result, these fringes cannot appear. That means, if these two sources are in very far distance, then fringe width becomes very less. As a result, these fringes cannot appear. Next, sixth condition was shown in this animation. If the light wave emerging from light source S1 and the light wave emerging from light source S2 to form an interference pattern at P on the screen, then the wavefronts of the interfering wavefronts must be traveling in the same direction or making very small angle with each other. Otherwise, there will be a decrease in spacing between the fringes and get mixed up. This animation clearly gives the picture of two waves are propagating with a small angle. Then only stable interference pattern is formed. In case two sources are not traveling in the same direction or making very small angle with each other, then there will be a decrease in spacing between the fringes and get mixed up. Hence, if the two sources satisfy this sixth condition, then only stable interference pattern is formed on the screen. So, this is our topic. So, please subscribe our Telugu Gamanam channel for more lecture videos. Click the bell icon for notifications. If you want to get lecture notes for this lecture video, click the description link below in the lecture video. Thank you for watching this video. See you again in the next lecture video. Have a nice day. Thank you one and all.